morning, students. So in the last class, we have seen some of the basics of algorithms. Every programmer, every algorithm contains basic three statements, and they are: one is input statement, which takes input data, and the second one is processing statement, by using which we are going to process the data according to the requirement of the output, and the third one is output statement. So basically, we accept input data using input statements, and after that we process according to the given task, and finally we are going to print the data by using output statements. And as already we have seen in the previous class, we can use any word which gives meaning that we are going to take something as input to the algorithm or program. So already in the last class we used read word for taking input data as well as write word for printing the output data, right? And also we have seen some of the algorithms, and all algorithms we have done by using simple concepts. Like what we have done in the previous class, we have written algorithm to find the addition of two numbers, sum and average of given some four numbers, and also we calculated the area of different shapes by applying formulas. Like area of circle can be calculated by using pi r square, where r is input data, radius is input data. And area of triangle can be calculated by taking half into base into height, in which two input values are required, base and height. Likewise, we have seen some examples. Now in today's session, we will see about... Hello? Clear undi kadanta?
Clear, sir.
Yeah. In today's session, we will see second category of statements. See, here, for example, in the previous class, what we did, say, my algorithm is to find the addition of two numbers. So what is our algorithm? Read A, comma B. And third instruction is C equals to A plus B, or sum equals to A plus B. And fourth one is write C. And the last one is stop. Totally, how many variables we used? Totally, we used three variables. Now, for any input values of A and B, remember, for any input values of A and B, the result is going to be calculated by using C equals to A plus B. So all the instructions are going to be executed in the sequential order. Meeru A ki B ki A values ichina sare, mee result etla calculate cheyabadutundi? Result will be calculated only by using C equals to A plus B instruction. Say, for example, as we used tracing process in the previous class, A, B, and this is C value. Suppose if I provide 10, 20, what is your output? C equals to A plus B, that is 30 will be calculated. Suppose if I provide some 150, 200, in that case, what is the value of A? Value of A is 150 and B is 200. Again, the result is going to be calculated by using the same instruction, that is C equals to 350 you are going to get. So this means in such simple algorithms, the result is going to be taken out, or result will be calculated only by using one statement. But there are many other situations are there where multiple possibilities are there for result. We will see example of that one. See here. Now, my task is to find the highest of two values. Suppose if I give A and B are given two values. Can you tell me which one is highest among these two values? Please, you can unmute yourself and you can answer. Answer A and very good. Interactive undali.
B, sir. B.
How can you say that B is highest? We did not provide any values for A and B. A ki B ki values ivaledu kabatti mee rendittlo edem cheptaru ikkada. You cannot decide because we did not provide any values for A and B. So you will say that, sir, if you want to find the highest of these two values, what are the possible answers? A may be highest, or B may be highest, or both values may be equal. These are the possible solutions for the given task. So out of these two, which one is highest? We cannot say. Suppose if I ask you, say 10 and 20, which one is highest? We will say 20 is highest. Suppose if I give 200 and 350, then you will answer 350 is highest value. But if I provide only two identifiers or two values A and B, what will be your solution? Your solution will be सर ए में भी हाईएस्ट और बी में भी हाईएस्ट और बोथ वैल्यूज में भी इक्वल, राइट? दीज आर द पॉसिबल आंसर्स, दीज आर द पॉसिबल आंसर्स. नाउ इफ आई प्रोवाइड ए इक्वल्स टू 50 एंड बी इक्वल्स टू 20, देन कैन यू टेल मी विच वन इज हाईएस्ट? नाउ यू विल से दैट बाय कंपेयरिंग दीज टू वैल्यूज एज ए इज हैविंग ग्रेटर वैल्यू देन बी, यू विल से दैट ए इज हाईएस्ट, ए इज हाईएस्ट. And suppose if I provide some 50 comma 70, in that case, what is your answer for the same problem? The answer is different now. In the previous case, what is your answer? What is our task? Our task is to find the highest of these two values. And when I provided 50 and 20, your answer is A is highest. And in the next case, when I changed my input data, 50 and 70, then your answer is different. What is that? Your answer is B is highest. Now, suppose if I provide 10 comma 10, in that case, you are going to say both values are equal. Now, so depending on the input data, there will be change in the output. Now, coming to the second point, I think you got the concept. See here, here is a problem which is having how many possible answers? Three possible answers are there. What are the three possibilities? Out of A and B, A can be highest and B can be highest and both values can be equal. And remember, whenever you write an algorithm or program, it must act for all kinds of input data. I mean, A input data is necessary, it should give proper result. Now, we have to decide when A can be highest. A put highest avutundi. When can A be highest? Now we can say when A is having kanabartunda. Kanabartunda.
Okay.
When A is having greater value than B, then you will say, remember, when A is having greater value than B, then only appude, then only we will say that A is highest. And similarly, when can we say that B is highest? We will say when B is greater than A. If this condition is true, then only we will say the second value is B is highest. And similarly, we can say when A value is equals to B value, then we can say both values are equal. So here we are, out of these three possible answers, remember, out of these three possible answers, in the algorithm, we have to define when each possible answer can become correct answer. And if they put correct answer, this will be the correct answer if and only if A is greater than B. Just by using some conditions, we are defining when these possibilities are going to become right answers. Now, simply we can read out, if A is greater than B, then we can say A is highest. If B is greater than A, then we can say B is highest. And if A equals to B, then we can say both values are equal. And remember, out of these three possible answers, how many correct answers you will get for a given input data? ఆన్సర్ అన్మ్యూట్ చేసుకుని చెప్పండి నాకు. ఈ మూడు పాసిబుల్ ఆన్సర్స్ ఉన్నాయి. దీంట్లో మనం ఒక ఇన్పుట్ డేటా ఇస్తే ఎన్ని కరెక్ట్ వస్తాయి ఇక్కడ మీకు? యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు గెట్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఇన్పుట్ డేటా. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఐ ప్రొవైడ్ దిస్ డేటా, దెన్ యువర్ ఆన్సర్ ఈస్ ఏ ఇస్ హైయెస్ట్ అండ్ దీస్ టు ఆర్ నాట్ కరెక్ట్ ఫర్ దిస్ డేటా. అండ్ సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఐ ప్రొవైడ్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డేటా, దెన్ యువర్ ఆన్సర్ ఈస్ బి ఇస్ హైయెస్ట్. సో అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ పాసిబిలిటీస్ హౌ మెనీ కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్స్ విల్ బి దేర్ ఫర్ గివెన్ ఇన్పుట్ డేటా? ఓన్లీ వన్ విల్ బి ద కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్, రైట్? And see here, these statements are called as conditional statements. We will take another example and after that directly we'll go to the algorithm. I think you are getting the concept. See here, let us take, I want to find out the grade of a student. Let us say I want to know grade of an intermediate student. What are the possible grades? What are the possible grades? Grade can be, grades are interconnected. A grade, a student can get A grade or B grade or C grade or D grade or E grade. These are the possible grades. A student can get either A grade or B grade or C grade or D grade or E grade. But you never find a student who will get A and B grade. Can you find a student? Evarikaina okariki A, B grades vachuntaya? Rendu grades raavu ikkada manaku. For any student, based on his marks, he'll get only one. He will be awarded only one grade. Now, we have to define when he can be the great. Now we can say when he is having some more than 80%, greater than or equal to 80% of marks, then we can say grade is A. And if it is between 70 and 80, then we can say grade is B. And if it is between 60 and 70%, then grade is C. And if it is in 50 and 60, then grade is D, like we are going to define some conditions. So this will become correct answer if and only if percentage is greater than or equals to 80. And this will become correct answer if and only if the percentage is between 70 and 80, right? But see here, out of these five possibilities, how many correct answers will be there for the given input data? But either possibilities tonight. The me percentage and then range at the record 75 and 75 and then what is your grade? Your grade is B, right? So when a problem is having more than one possible solution, when a problem is having more than one possible solution. See here in the previous case, what is our algorithm? We calculated the addition of two numbers. So in that case, always we are going to find out the solution by using C equals to A plus B. But here, depending on it, for all kinds of input data, we calculate the result only by using the same instruction, that is C equals to A plus B. They are simple statements. And here, depending on input data, the result, there may be change in the result, right? So these are called as conditional statements. Based on some conditions, we have to define when each possibility is going to become correct answer. When each possibility will become correct answer. Now we can say, if percentage is greater than 80, then only grade is A. If percentage is between 70 and 80, then only grade is B. See here, if means this is condition. Aithe ene ani cheptunnam ikkada manam. So these kinds of statements are called as conditional statements, right? Now,
sir,
yes, please. Cheppandi amma.
Less than, greater than or equal to ani icham ga sir, grade A lo.
Avunandi.
Equal to ani akkada ichinappudu ikkada 70 to 80 ani isthe accept chestunna sir, B grade kosam amma.
Less than untundi condition rasthanu ippudu nenu ide. ఇక్కడ లెస్ దెన్ ఉంటుంది, ఇక్కడ లెస్ దెన్ ఉంటుంది, ఇక్కడ లెస్ దెన్ ఉంటుంది, బిట్వీన్ అన్నాను నేను. ఓకే, మీరు ప్రాపర్ గా కండిషన్ రాసుకోవాలంటే దీనికి ఏమొస్తుందంటే గ్రేటర్ దెన్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు 70 అండ్ లెస్ దెన్ 80 ఇట్లా రాసుకుంటూ పోవాలి. వి విల్ రైట్ దోస్ అల్గోరిథమ్స్ నౌ. ఐ లైక్ అల్గోరిథమ్ ఫర్ దీస్ టు ఆల్సో. దీన్ని కూడా రాస్తాను, గ్రేటర్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు 60 అండ్ లెస్ దెన్ 70 అండ్ సిమిలర్లీ this is greater than or equals to 50 and less than 60, right? These are the possibilities. Now these statements are called as conditional statements. These statements are called as conditional statements. So based on conditions, we are going to define when each possibility will become correct answer. Now let us go back to our previous example, that is to find the highest of two values. How many possibilities are there? There are three possibilities. A can be highest or B can be highest or both values may be equal. Now, how many input values are required for this? Two input values. Let us come to the algorithm. See here. Start. Board ikkada ganavartundi point. Start. Next. Read. A comma B. We are accepting two input values. And now, what is our task? Our task is to find the highest of these two values. Now see here, what is our first possibility? Our first possibility is A is highest. Eppudu A is highest avutundi akkada manaku, if and only if A is having greater value than B. So we write the condition, if A is greater than B, then only we can say A is highest. 3.1 will be executed if and only if this condition is true. For a condition, how many possibilities will be there? There are two possibilities, either it can be true or false. The following statement will be executed if and only if the condition is true. Similarly, we can write fourth one, that is to define the next possibility. When B is greater than A, then write is highest. This is 4.1 will be executed if and only if both condition is true. And similarly, we can say, and remember here you practice two equal symbols, because we in C language we use two equal symbols for checking the relational equal. Rendu equal kada check cheyadaniki rendu equals vartham kabatti ikka nunchi meeru you try to use two equal symbols. Then your task is, that is, to both values are equal, and finally stop. Now one more question. We already concluded that out of three possibilities for a given input data, only one will be the correct answer. Only one will be the correct answer. So coming to this algorithm, here we are accepting two input values. One is for A and one is for B. And after that, we are checking this condition. If this condition is true, then only this will be executed. See here, I can represent this symbolically. We will check the condition. It will check the condition. This is a flow diagram. This is a condition. For a condition, how many possibilities are there? There are two possibilities. One, it can be true, or one, it can be false. When it is true, the statements, whatever enclosed in that condition, will be executed. After that, control will come out. When condition is false, control will come out directly without executing those statements. It will go to the next statement. See here, if the condition is true, its inner statements will be executed. After that, control will come out. Control means program execution pointer. When this condition is false, directly control will come out, and starting from the next statement, remaining will be executed. Now, if this condition is true, then 3.1 will be executed. If this condition is false, then directly control goes to fourth statement, and similarly it will check the next condition. If it is true, the following will be executed, and if it is false, then it will go to the next one. And now you tell me, in this example we have taken three conditions. For a given input data, how many conditions will become true and how many conditions will become false? Cheppan, unmute chesukoni. For a given input data, how many conditions will become true and how many conditions will become false?
One will become true and two will become false.
Only one condition will become true and the remaining two will become false. Because out of any number of possibilities, let us assume that a problem is having n possibilities. And out of those n possibilities, how many correct answers will be there? Only one will be the correct answer. But my class lopala 60 మంది ఉన్నారు, 60 మెంబర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, అండ్ ఐ వాంట్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్ యువర్ రూల్ నెంబర్. హౌ మెనీ పాసిబిలిటీస్ ఆర్ దేర్? 60 పాసిబిలిటీస్. మీది వన్ కావచ్చు, టూ కావచ్చు, త్రీ కావచ్చు, అప్పుడు 60 ఏదైనా కావచ్చు. బట్ ఆ 60 ఎన్ని కరెక్ట్ అవుతాయి మీకు ఇక్కడ? ఓన్లీ వన్ ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్, వన్ నెంబర్ ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్. రిమైనింగ్ 59 ఆర్ ఫాల్స్ రూల్ నెంబర్స్ ఫర్ యూ. సో అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ పాసిబిలిటీస్, ఓన్లీ వన్ విల్ బి ద కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ అండ్ రిమైనింగ్ ఎన్ వన్ విల్ బికమ్ ఫాల్స్. లెట్ అస్ ట్రేస్ దిస్ వన్. ట్రేస్ చేద్దాం. ఇది రాసుకున్నారా మీరు? If you want, you can write it.
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Yes, sir.
We will trace this algorithm so that you will understand this in a better way. Okay. Otherwise, you can take screenshot also. Okay.
Okay.
So now we will trace this one. Serial number, A value, B value, first condition A is greater than B, second condition B is greater than A, third condition A equals to B, and last one is output. Is it visible to all? Yes. Okay. In the tracing process, what we have taken, ekkada manam data check chestunnama, check points anni kuda table raaskunnanu. First variable A, second variable B, third one is condition A is greater than B, because based on this also we took some actions, second condition, third condition, and finally What will be your output? Serial number 1, start. First instruction, statement number. Next, it will take input data. Let us say some 10 and 20 we have taken. What is the value of A? After the second instruction, value of A is 10. Value of B is 20. Now see here. Coming to the third instruction, if A is greater than B, then this will be executed. Now you apply the values and you take the condition. 10 is greater than 20. Is it true or false? Condition is false.
Does not exist.
Condition is false. So when this condition is false, it won't go further to execute its statements. Mundukeli it execute chesukodu intu mundu diagram lo chupichanu meeku. So what happens? As condition is false, it goes to the next statement. That is, it comes to fourth statement. And here again, one more condition is there. It will check that condition. What is that condition? B is greater than A. What is the value of B? 20. 20 is greater than 10. Is it true or false? True.
True, sir.
When this condition is true, what happens? It goes to execute its statements. What is that statement? Write B is highest. B is highest. And coming to the next statement, simply it will come out and it will check the next condition. 10 equals 20. Condition is false. Here, we have taken 10 and 20 and how many conditions became true and how many conditions became false. Only one is true and the remaining two are false. Even suppose if we take 10 comma 10, in that case, this will become false, this will become false and this will become true. And your answer will be both values are equal. So here, statements will be executed based on conditions. And these statements are called as conditional statements. So based on conditions, it will be decided whether to execute the following statements or not. And in our C language, we use conditional statements by using if statement. C kadu, meeta almost any language lo kuda, if e vaadtara kada. There will be slight difference in syntax usage. Is it clear, all of you? Okay, na? Yeah. Here, we will see two more terms. Important terms. One is time complexity. And the second one is space. Okay, time being just, we will see only time complexity. First one is time complexity.
Sir, board is not appearing.
Board can never appear.
Yes, sir. No, sir. By time.
Fine, I'm going to tell you part.
Ah, yes, sir.
Fine, I'm going to tell you.
Ah, on, sir.
See. Here we will see two terms, time complexity and second one, space complexity. Right? See here, my task is to find the multiplication of 3 into 4. I want to find the product of 3 and 4. What is your equation? What method you will follow to find the product of 3 into 4? 3 and 4. Em vartaru akkada meeru? One can return 3 into 4 equals to 12 and rasesadu. Inkothane em rayachu? 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. Which one is correct among these two? Both are right. Both are right. But methods are different. But methods are different. Successive additions is nothing but multiplication. So now, if I ask you, among these two, which one is good method? Which one is good method? So to calculate that, a program can be written by using many number of logics. Okay, the same program add aniki chala different logics kuda untayi. Now, let us assume that programmer one, person one written a program by using method one. Person two written the same program by using second method. Person three written the same program by using third method. ఈ మోడిట్ల లోపల ఏది మంచి ప్రోగ్రామ్, ఏది క్వాలిటీ ప్రోగ్రామ్ అనేది ఎట్లా డిసైడ్ చేస్తారు ఇక్కడ? సో టు డిసైడ్ ద క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రోగ్రామ్ మేజర్లీ టూ థింగ్స్ విల్ బి టేకెన్ ఇన్ టు ద కన్సిడరేషన్. దేర్ వన్ ఈస్ టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ అండ్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఈస్ స్పేస్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ. టైమ్ బీయింగ్ వీ వోంట్ వరీ అబౌట్ స్పేస్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ, బట్ ఎట్ దిస్ పాయింట్ వీ ట్రై టు నో ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ. టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ మీన్స్ time taken to complete the process is called as time complexity. What is time complexity? Time taken to complete the process is called as time complexity. Atlage cheppalante andi mana program execute kavadaniki patte time ne emantam manam, we call it as time complexity. Now I'll tell you one example. My program is to travel from, మీరంతా వరంగల్ అనుకుంటాను, ఐ వాంట్ టు ట్రావెల్ ఫ్రమ్ హనుమకొండ టు వరంగల్. మై ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇస్ టు ట్రావెల్ ఫ్రమ్ హనుమకొండ టు వరంగల్. ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ ఎట్ హనుమకొండ ఎట్ 11 AM అండ్ ఐ రీచ్డ్ వరంగల్ ఎట్ 11:30 AM. కెన్ యూ టెల్ మీ వాట్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ ఆఫ్ మై ప్రోగ్రామ్?
30 మినిట్స్.
So time taken to complete the process is called as time complexity. So a good program must take less time complexity. That means that should be executed more faster than other programs. Must take less time complexity. Idu enduku cheptunnanante manam C language lo same conditional statement cheppe appudu ఏ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఎప్పుడు ఎక్కడ ఎందుకు వాడాలి, ఏది వాడితే మనకు టైం తగ్గుతుంది అనేది ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేయడానికి ఈ వర్డ్ ఇక్కడ తీసుకుంటున్నాను నేను. ఐల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దట్ వన్ ఆల్సో. సో టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ మీన్స్ టైమ్ టేకెన్ టు కంప్లీట్ ద ప్రాసెస్ ఆర్ ఎగ్జిక్యూషన్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ. సో హౌ మచ్ టైమ్ ఇట్ వాస్ టేకెన్ టు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ మై ప్రోగ్రామ్, దట్ ఈస్ ట్రావెలింగ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్, 30 మినిట్స్. సో వీ కెన్ సే 30 మినిట్స్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రోగ్రామ్. సిమిలర్లీ స్పేస్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ complexity can be decided space taken in the program. Of course it will take some space for A and B, that is not important here. Just try to remember the definition. Space taken for the data is called as space complexity. Now see here, I think it is clear, time complexity. So out of these three methods, whichever takes less time complexity, that will be treated as a good qualitative program. దాన్ని మంచి ప్రోగ్రామ్ అంటాం మనం. నౌ హౌ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ టైమ్ కాంప్లెక్సిటీ ఫర్ ఎ ప్రోగ్రామ్? మన ఇదంతా కూడా తర్వాత మీరు నేర్చుకుంటారు క్లియర్గా యూజింగ్ సమ్ నోటేషన్స్, బట్ హియర్ వి టేక్ సమ్ అజంప్షన్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ డిఫరెంట్ సింటాక్సెస్. నేను ఇక్కడ ఏమనుకుంటున్నాను, మై కంపైలర్, మై ప్రాసెసర్ ఈజ్ టేకింగ్ టీ టైమ్ టు చెక్ వన్ కండిషన్. రిమెంబర్, my processor is taking t time to check one condition. So for 10 conditions, how much time it will take? 10t time it will take to check 10 conditions. It will take 10t time to check 100 conditions. It will take 100t time. Assume that idi standard kaadu, meeku ardham kavalani cheptunnanu. Meeku tarvata meeru further classes ki vellin tarvata you will learn in detail how to calculate time complexity. So to check one condition, assume that our processor is taking T time. Can you tell me totally how much time it will take to execute this program? How many conditions are there here? Three conditions are there. Condition one, condition two, condition three. How much time it will take? It will take
T time.
So overall we can say, ఇప్పుడు మీకు ఏంటంటే అర్థం కావడానికి ఓన్లీ కండిషన్స్కే చెప్తున్నాను, స్టేట్మెంట్స్ కూడా తీసుకుంటుంది. సో ఇట్ విల్ ఓవరాల్ హౌ మచ్ టైమ్ ఇట్ విల్ టేక్? ఇట్ విల్ టేక్ 3 టైమ్. జస్ట్ ఐఎమ్ లివింగ్ ఆల్ ద రిమైనింగ్ స్టేట్మెంట్, జస్ట్ వీఆర్ కన్సిడరింగ్ ఓన్లీ ద కండిషన్స్. సో హౌ మచ్ టైమ్ ఇట్ విల్ టేక్? ఇట్ విల్ టేక్ 3t టైమ్. అండ్ కెన్ యూ టెల్ మీ కండిషన్ ఇఫ్ ద వెదర్ ద కండిషన్ ఇస్ ట్రూ ఆర్ ఫాల్స్, విల్ ఇట్ స్పెండ్ టైమ్ టు చెక్ దట్ కండిషన్? Yes, either the condition is true or false, whatever it may be the result of the condition, it will spend a time to check that condition. So either it is true or false, it will take t time, right? So what is our final conclusion? As we have taken three conditions, it will spend 3 t time to check all the three conditions. Okay, ardhamaindi kada adi? Yes. Let us go to the next algorithm. Our next algorithm is to find whether the given number is positive. I want to find out the charge of a number. What are the possibilities? It can be either positive or negative or zero. It can be either positive or negative or zero. Suppose if n is the given number, what are the possibilities? Possibilities are it can be positive or it can be negative or it can be zero.
Zero.
How many possibilities are there? There are three possibilities. Remember, we are writing instructions to the machine. Computer ki, we are writing instructions to the machine. So we need to specify what to do at every moment. We need to write all the things very clearly. So now we have to define when n can be positive. The next question is when n can be positive, when n can be negative, when n can be zero. So what is our number system? Generally our number system is 0, 1, 2, 3, positive, infinity, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Minus infinity. This is our number system. And this is called as zero. All these are numbers are positive numbers. All these are negative numbers. Now you frame an equation. When n is a given value, when can you say that n is positive, n is negative, and n is zero? A number which is less than zero is called as negative. A number which is greater than 0 is called as positive. And if it is equals to 0, then we can say that is 0. So, what are the conditions? If n is greater than 0, then we can say that is positive. If n is less than 0, then that is negative. When it is equals to 0, then we can say that is 0. So, before writing the program, we have to do some manual work. Then only you can understand the program very clearly and easily you can write if you understand it once. So here everything is clear. This problem is having three possibilities. One is positive, one is negative, and third one is zero. Now we define three conditions for deciding three possibilities. Okay, shall we go for the algorithm?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, start, read. How many input values are required? Can you tell me? Can anyone tell?
Only one.
That is N. Very good. Third one. So what is our first condition? First condition is if N is greater than zero, then what is that?
Write n is equals to positive.
N is positive. You can write anything. Your own comment you can write. Positive. And if n is less than 0, then
n is negative.
Negative.
Right. Negative. And similarly, if n equals to 0, then
0
equal. Given value or n is 0.
Zero.
That's it. Can you tell me the time complexity of this one? Again, as in three conditions, we assume that it will take 3 t time. Because of our three time required.
Three conditions.
Right. Is it clear? I think no need to check.
Yes, sir.
Process. Yes, sir. It's clear.
out of these three conditions, for any given input value, one condition will become true and the remaining will become false. Right? Till now, any doubts? Conditional statements?
No, sir.
Okay. No, sir.
Now we will see another one where we can see the difference in time complexity. Unmute, you have to answer for my questions, right? So let us say these values n1, n2, n3, n4. Four values are there. Can you tell me which one is highest?
We no, can't say, sir.
We cannot tell, sir.
Why we can't say?
Values are not
values given. Not given.
Okay, but when we did not provide values for A and B, you said that A can be or B can be. What are the possibilities?
A or B or C or D, sir.
One possibility. So
one possibility. So you will say that either N1 can be highest or
N2 or N3 or N4.
Or N4.
N1.
So possibilities N1 can be highest. Is it visible here?
No, sir.
N1 can be highest, or N2 can be highest, or N3 can be highest, or N4 can be okay. So these are the possible answers. These are the possible answers. Now, when can you say that N1 is highest? N1, if it is highest, chance on the when it can become highest?
Value.
Remaining three or
less. If a value of N1 is greater than all the values.
Remaining values.
Yes, very good. So, your solution is you can say that N1 is high. N1 is highest if and only if N1 is having greater value than N2 and N1 is having
greater than
N3 and N1 is having greater value than N4. Then only you will say that N1 is highest. How many conditions you are checking to decide whether N1 is highest or not?
Three conditions.
Three conditions.
Very good. And similarly, how many conditions are required for N2? So
three conditions, sir.
You can say that N2 is highest when it is having greater value than N1.
N3, N4.
N3 and N4.
So again, you can say, here also it will take 3T conditions. And here also how many conditions are required?
Three conditions.
Three conditions required. And here also it takes three conditions.
Three conditions.
Can you tell me totally how many conditions you are going to check in your program? Of course, out of these four possibilities, only one will become true and the remaining will become false. Either this condition will become true, or this will become true, or this
anyone.
Will become or this one.
Anyone.
Whether it is true or false, condition will be verified. So it will spend some time. So altogether, how much time it will take? 3 plus 3 3T. That is 12 TT. Time. Are you getting the point or not?
Yes, sir.
So, if I want to decide the highest of four values, and if I follow this method, how many conditions it will check? It will check almost all 12 conditions. Somebody. Now we will see other method where we try to reduce the time complexity. See here. I think you understood this method. Any disturbance? Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir. It's clear, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, what is our task? Our task is to find the highest of four values.
Sir, 1 second, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
Student, when you are speaking, just speak and immediately unmute yourself.
Sir.
all are getting some disturbance. So after speaking, immediately mute yourself. Okay, thank you.
Okay. So what is our task? Our task is to find the highest of four values. And what are the four values? N1, N2, N3, and N4. Now I'm using one more variable. What is that? That is highest. What is that? That is highest. I'll write here. That is highest. Let us take some values for N1, 40, 50, some 30, and 70. So when we follow the previous method, how many conditions we have to check, or it will check? It will check approximately 12 conditions, and the time complexity will be calculated as 12 almost all. Just we have taken this example to for your understanding purpose. Now, in the second method, what I am doing is, I am assuming the first value itself is highest. I am assuming that first value itself is highest. What is the first value? N1 value, that is 40. So far I considered only one number, and I am treating that as highest. In the next step, we compare second element and our present highest. Second element and our present highest. So what is the second element? Second element is 50 and our highest value is 40. Highest value is 40. Now out of these two, I am going to move highest value into this highest. Which one is highest? Either N2 or highest. లేదా మీరు ఇక్కడ కన్ఫ్యూజ్ కాకుండానికి వర్డ్ అదే వాడుతున్నాం కాబట్టి జస్ట్ యూ టేక్ మ్యాక్సిమం. సో ఇన్ ద ఫస్ట్ స్టేజ్ ఐఎమ్ కాపీయింగ్ ఫస్ట్ వాల్యూ యాజ్ హైయెస్ట్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ అవర్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్? మ్యాక్సిమం ఈక్వల్స్ టు N1, దట్ ఈస్ 40. ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ స్టెప్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు కంపేర్ ద వాల్యూస్ ఆఫ్ N2 అండ్ మ్యాక్సిమం. And if N2 is greater than our present maximum, N2 value will be moved into the maximum. Remember, in the first case, in the first step, we have taken N1 as highest. Now it is 40. And now we will take the second element. Second element is N2. And we copy value of N2 into maximum, if and only if N2 is having greater value than present maximum. The maximum lo em untundi, always we maintain a present maximum. So far we considered only one value, so the maximum value is 40. Now I am going to consider the second one. So we compare these two values. Which one is highest? We compare for 50 and 40. If N2 is greater than maximum, 50 is greater than 40, so out of these two, 50 will be moved into the maximum. So what is your statement? Your statement is, if N2 is greater than present maximum, that is maximum, then maximum equals to N2. See here, apply the same thing. Maximum equals to N1, that is 40. And the second condition, N2 is greater than maximum. N2 is 50, present maximum is 40, 50 is greater than 40, condition is true, then N2 will be copied into the maximum. Now third step, again we are going to do the same process. We compare N3 value with maximum. If N3 is having greater value, see here, now so far we considered, we have taken two values and the maximum is holding highest of these two values. Maximum is holding highest of these two values. Now I'm comparing 30 and 50. Shall I move N3 into maximum? No, because N3 is not having greater value than present maximum. So even though after the comparison, as condition means as N3 is not greater than 50, that value will not be moved into maximum. So what is the next condition? N3 can be moved when it will be moved into the maximum? When entry is having greater value than maximum, present maximum, then that will be moved. See here, coming to the condition, entry is 30 and maximum is 50. 30 is greater than 50, condition is false, so this will not be executed. Now, similarly, the same process will be done between these two values, 70 and 50. And the, again, same process, N4 will be moved into the maximum, if and only if N4 is greater than maximum. That statement is, if N4 is greater than max, then maximum equals to N4. Did you get the point? So first number we have taken, that itself is highest. Next, from the next step onwards, we are taking one value and we are comparing with present maximum. If the new value is greater than present maximum, we are taking that new value into maximum. Otherwise, maximum remains with the same value. The same process applicable for all the values. Now, that's it, your algorithm. How many conditions have we taken totally? 1, 2, 3. Finally, what is your output statement? Output is max. So coming to the algorithm, algorithm is start, and how many input values are required? N1, N2, N3, N4, and of course, maximum will be calculated. Third instruction, 4, 4.1, 5, 5.1, 6, 6.1, 7, and finally, 8th one is stop. We will trace this one. We will trace this. I'll write this as condition 1, condition 2, condition 3, and condition 4, because space is not.
Sir, doubt, sir.
Yeah, okay, chepandi.
Sir, in the fifth condition, N3 is less than maximum, sir.
N3 is less than
maximum. Then the maximum value will become N2, na, sir.
That's what we will see. See here. Here we are not copying, because manan teesukune data ki this condition will become false. N3 value will be moved into the maximum. Manam ikkada what we are doing here is simply we are going to copy new value into maximum when new value is having greater value than present maximum. Mana daggara unnatuvanti present maximum lo kante kotta value ekku unnapudu aa kotta value ni maximum ku move chestam manam. So here we have taken all the conditions when we are going to move values into maximum, and obviously values will be moved into the maximum if and only if they are having greater values. Let us retrace this. N1, N2, N3, N4, condition 1, condition 1, condition 2, condition 3, and this is maximum. Is it converted in the maximum? Yeah. Tell me some values. So 50, 40, 70, and 60. So these values we have taken from the keyboard. Max equals to N1. What is the value of max? Max is, please answer, 50, which will be copied into maximum. That is 50.
Sir, board not appearing.
Can you convert it later?
Yes. Left side over it.
Maximum. Right? Because space, here space is not sufficient, so I'm writing here. Or I'll rub it. I think, hope you have taken that one. Otherwise, you can copy from the video. So these are the things we have taken in the algorithm. Now we will trace this one. This is the main logic of the algorithm. So read N1, N2, N3, N4. We have taken four input values. Next instruction is max equals to N1 directly without any comparison. First value itself will be treated as maximum, that will be copied into max. So after this instruction, value of max is 50. Okay. Coming to the second one, we are comparing N2 and maximum. What is our present maximum? 50. ఇప్పుడు మాక్సిమంలోకి ఏం రావాలి, వస్తే ఏదైనా వాల్యూ 50 కంటే ఎక్కువ ఉంటేనే రావాలి, 50 కంటే తక్కువ ఉంటే రాకూడదు. సో సి హియర్, ఇఫ్ ఎన్ టూ ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ మ్యాక్సిమమ్ దెన్ ఓన్లీ మూవ్ ఎన్ టూ టు మ్యాక్సిమమ్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ టూ? ఎన్ టూ ఈజ్ 40, 40 ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ 50. ఈజ్ ఇట్ ట్రూ ఆర్ ఫాల్స్? కండిషన్ ఈజ్ ఫాల్స్. సో వెన్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఫాల్స్, దిస్ విల్ నాట్ బి ఎగ్జిక్యూటెడ్. ఓకే, సో దేర్ ఆర్ నో చేంజెస్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటింగ్ ద కండిషన్ బికాజ్ ఫాల్స్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్, వాట్ అబౌట్ దిస్ వన్? వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ ఎంట్రీ ఈజ్ 70. 70 ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్
ట్రూ సార్.
వెన్ దిస్ కండిషన్ ఈజ్ ట్రూ, ద ఫాలోయింగ్ స్టేట్మెంట్ విల్ బి ఎగ్జిక్యూటెడ్, దట్ ఈస్ ఎంట్రీ ఈజ్ ఎంట్రీ విల్ బి
గ్రేటర్ దెన్ మ్యాక్స్.
సో 70 విల్ బి మూవ్డ్ ఇంటు మాక్సిమం. నౌ ద ప్రెసెంట్ వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ మాక్సిమం ఈజ్
70.
నెక్స్ట్ థర్డ్ కండిషన్, దట్ ఈస్ N4 is greater than maximum. What is the value of N4? That is 60. Condition is false. So then this will not be executed. This will not be executed. There is no change. So finally, write maximum. What is the value of maximum? That is, your output is 70. Out of these four values, which one is highest? 70 is highest. You please do one thing. After this class, you draw the table, you take నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ శాంపుల్ డేటా, మీరు ఎగ్జాంపుల్ డేటా తీసుకుని యూ ట్రేస్ అల్గోరిథం, రైట్? సో హౌ మెనీ కండిషన్స్ హ్యావ్ బీ టుక్? 1, 2, 3. ఓన్లీ అవర్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ విల్ టేక్ 3T టైమ్ టు డిసైడ్ హైయెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ 4 వాల్యూస్. హైయెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ 4 వాల్యూస్. అర్థమైందా ఇది?
Yes, sir.
టైప్ చేయండి చాట్ బాక్స్ లో, ఎస్ఆర్ నో అని టైప్ చేసేసేయండి, సరిపోతుంది. డౌట్ సెక్షన్ పెట్టుకుందామా సార్?
యా, జస్ట్ ఫైనల్లీ వన్ సెకండ్. సో ఇఫ్ ఐ సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ద హైయెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ 100 వాల్యూస్, ఇఫ్ ఐ యూజ్ ద ప్రీవియస్ మెథడ్, దట్ ఈస్ టు కంపేర్ విత్ ఆల్ ద రిమైనింగ్ వాల్యూస్, హౌ మెనీ కండిషన్స్ విల్ టేక్ టు చెక్ ఓన్లీ వన్ వాల్యూ? ఇట్ విల్ టేక్ 99 conditions. So 99 into 100, those many conditions it will take to decide the highest of 100 values. Whereas by using this method, how many conditions it will take? Out of 4 values, it was taken only 3 conditions. And for 100 values, it will take obviously 99 conditions. See the difference between time complexity. So using program logic, we are able to reduce number of conditions. See, all of you, please, students, you take this algorithm and you draw the table, you take sample input data and you apply in the conditions and you see the result, then you'll understand very clearly, right? Yeah, let us go for a doubt session.
So anyone, meek edana doubts unte chat box lo adagandam. అందరు నోట్స్ మెయింటైన్ చేయండి. వాట్ ఈస్ ద యూస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ టైం కంపోనెంట్?
ఐ విల్ గివ్ యు థియరీ నోట్స్ ఆల్సో, ఐ విల్ సెండ్ యాస్ పిడిఎఫ్ ఫైల్ యాస్ అండ్ వెన్ రిక్వైర్డ్. సో టుమారో విల్ స్టార్ట్ బేసిక్స్ ఆఫ్ సి లాంగ్వేజ్. నౌ వి హావ్ రిటన్ బై యూజింగ్ సింపుల్ సెంటెన్సెస్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్ వి రైట్ బై యూజింగ్ సి లాంగ్వేజ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్, దట్ విల్ బికమ్ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్.
సార్ వన్ క్వశ్చన్.
యా
సార్, టైం కాంప్లెక్స్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద యూస్ ఆఫ్ ద టైం కాంప్లెక్సిటీ? సంధ్య రాణి.
సీ, టు డిసైడ్ ద క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రోగ్రామ్, టైం కాంప్లెక్సిటీ విల్ బి కన్సిడర్డ్ టేకెన్ ఇన్ టు ద కన్సిడరేషన్. చూడండి అమ్మా, ఇప్పుడు మీరు హన్మకుడు నుంచి వరంగల్కి వెళ్ళాలి, సేమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాము కదా. మీరు 45 minutes టైం తీసుకున్నారు, మీ ఫ్రెండ్ 30 minutes టైం తీసుకున్నారు, ఇంకో పర్సన్ 15 minutes టైం తీసుకున్నారు. ఇందులో ఎవరిది బెస్ట్ వే అంటాం మనం ఇక్కడ? ద పర్సన్ హూ వాస్ టేకెన్ 15 minutes, బికాస్ అతని టైం సేవ్ అవుతుంది, రెండవది అతని కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ట్రావెలింగ్ కూడా రిడ్యూస్ అవుతుంది అక్కడ. ఎస్, ఎనీ మోర్
సార్? ఇఫ్ N1 అండ్ N2 వాల్యూస్ ఈక్వల్,
That's what you apply in the condition and you check whatever the doubt student is. In programming language, adagadam kante you apply values and you check that one. Then you will come to know. See here, let us take all equal values. 10, 10, 10, 10. What is the maximum? Maximum is 10. What about this condition? 10 is greater than 10. Is it true or false? 10 greater than 10. True or false? That is false. No change. False. No change. False. No change. Finally, maximum depends remains with 10 only. So, you check the algorithm by taking, yes, good doubt. You provide all equal values. You take negative values and you do in all by giving all varieties of input data. Okay.
Explain time and space complexity.
Time complexity means program execution time of the program is called as time complexity. Space complexity means space occupied for the program is called as space complexity. Space complexity is not required at this moment.
Is Balaguru Swami author book good for learning C?
Yes, that is very good. You can take that one and you can follow.
Can time complexity be zero? Adarsh.
Big? Yeah, notation. Can time complexity be zero? No, that is big O. See, I already told you that when you enter into data structures and algorithms concept, you will learn standard notations of time complexity. I am teaching for basic students. So to understand certain logics, we need to take word time complexity into the picture. There are notations are there, big O notation, small O notation, omega notation, theta notation. Notations are there. That
sir, can you send notes of C?
Yeah, I'll give.
Sir, will send within our group?
Yeah, yeah. I will send when it is required. As and when it is required, I will send the notes also.
You are also maintaining some notes. Okay. Can we close the session?
Yeah, okay.
Lakshmi Raghu.
Yeah, please.
So complex numbers will be accepted.
Complex numbers?
Will they accept it or not, sir?
Yeah, we can read complex numbers, but we have to use different format. That we will see. That we will see in structures concept. Last but one unit.
Okay, sir.
See, using program in programs, we can handle all kinds of data. Meeku mundu mundu kelthunte, you'll come to know how to handle the things. See here, I'll give you one assignment. Will you do that one? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Take only 2 minutes of time. You try to do it at your home. And see here, the very important thing is you have to do paperwork. You have to analyze the thing. The ultimate thing is to get the result. We don't mind what kind of method you are adopting for getting the result. Right? See here. So there is a point. What are the possibilities of this point? What are the possibilities?
Four possibilities.
It can be in first coordinate, or can be in second coordinate, or third, or fourth. These are the four possibilities, right? Or it can be at origin also. Or it can be on positive x-axis. This is positive x, negative x, positive y, negative y. And it can be on negative x-axis, it can be on positive x-axis, it can be on negative y-axis, positive y-axis, negative y-axis. Totally, how many possibilities are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 possibilities are there. Now you have to write a program. Possibilities, conditional statements we have to use. Now you have to think. See here, suppose if I provide 10, 20. X is 10 and Y is 20. Then what is your answer? Please answer. Chepandi.
First quadrant.
First coordinate. Very good. Minus 5, minus 7.
Third quadrant.
Third.
Third. Very good.
Third quadrant.
0, you know the logic for deciding the position of the point, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, whatever the calculations you have done in your mind, you please keep it as instructions. That will become your program. So what you did, take 10 and 20. 10 is positive and x is positive and y is positive. See here. Here, what are the values? X is positive and y is positive. You compare these two values. 10 is greater than 0 and 20 is greater than 0. Then you decided the point lies in first coordinate. So what is your condition? Your condition will become x is greater than 0 and y is greater than 0. Then you will say point lies in first coordinate. Similarly, you have to write for all possibilities. Like, you try to do this program, otherwise we'll see in the next class, right? Okay?
Sure. Can we close the session?
Yeah.
Close the Dhamma class?
Yes, sir.
There are no doubts.
Upload, yes, sir. Yes, sir. So 1 or 2 hours of video link put us in. మళ్ళీ రీక్యాప్ చేసుకోండి ఒకసారి కన్నా సార్ రాజేష్ కన్నా సార్ ప్రతిరోజు అంటే క్లాస్ స్టార్ట్ అయ్యే ముందు ప్రీవియస్ క్లాస్ రీక్యాప్ ఒకటి క్లాస్ అయిపోయినాక ఒక సమ్మరీ క్లాస్ అనేది ఒకటి అని అడుగుతుంది సార్
when it is required we will do that one today we did the recap also so in the last class what we did we have seen about the input statements and after that we have seen some of the algorithms and we have given that recap hope maybe that student entered lately notes when it is required I'll give you the notes
thank you very much sir
starting thank you concept, sir we will give right thank you very much
thank you everyone
bye sir